Slaughterhouse shutdowns are disrupting the U.S. food supply chain, leading to shortages of meat at retail stores and forcing farmers to humanely kill hogs and cattle.
It is Monday, the 27th of April, 2020, and let's discuss social distancing for a minute. I'll play you a couple of radio clips that I heard this morning. Now, predictive programming. They're going to keep talking about, oh, maybe we should get used to it. No, you know, 6 feet apart, and nobody knows when any of the bans are going to be lifted, and yada yada, so on and so forth. And they'll say it all blasé. Like, man, you know, you get used to it, yada yada. That's when you have to pay attention, because they're telling you exactly what is coming.
You are likely going to be seeing all these things that that we currently do, i.e. the distance, like physical distance, the encouragement of the physical distance between people, perhaps the masks in public, the plexiglass in retail stores, etc. Right, all the things that we've gotten used to are most likely going to stick around through the summer, even as things begin to reopen. We don't know exactly when that could be curtailed, but if you were asking me to guess, I would say that a decent guess would probably be when the vaccine happens. So that means get used to it for the rest of the year.
Now, consider any event in history, right? Or at least the history that they give us. Anything that was considered life-altering, a changing of the guard, so to speak. Don't be surprised if in the next 20 years, the generation being born now looks at us like we're the freaks for actually going to a movie with other people. They're going to be born in to social distancing, and it's going to be normal for the generation to come. They're going to say, wow, how did you guys ever survive out there? Going to dinner with people, it's so much easier to just grab your food on the sidewalk and go home, right? Cell phones, it's so much easier. Everything is so much easier. Again, look at history. And I find it fascinating that social distancing, let's do a little gematria. Right? Social distancing is 69, right? Full reduction. Do you find it a coincidence that event 201 is 69 English ordinal? Pandemic fears, 69 in single reduction. You can top that off with the New World Order being 69 in reverse, full reduction. This is planned. It's part of the script. You just have to be prepared. Life is changing. We have to be prepared for it. You can throw checkmate in English ordinal being 69 in numerology. Because that's what this is all about, and I find it no coincidence that checkmate is also 33 in full reduction. They're also pushing winter. I'll play you this little clip right here.
The government has just put a little more meat into the rules for the industry's practices during the pandemic.
I'm Jim Krasula. The Labor Department has issued new guidelines for meatpacking and meat processing plants where there have been thousands of coronavirus cases. Employees will be spaced at least 6 feet apart and screened before they start working. Slaughterhouse shutdowns are disrupting the U.S. food supply chain, leading to shortages of meat at retail stores and forcing farmers to humanely kill hogs and cattle.
Be prepared. They're telling you that there is a problem. They're telling you all through summer. They're telling you you might have a problem this winter. Prepare now, and don't prepare with a whole bunch of extra meat. If you can, get it now and put it in a freezer. If you do that, you better have a generator with a lot of gasoline as a backup to keep that running. I said it in my last video, go for those 5 gallon food grade buckets, fill them up with rice, fill them up with kidney beans, pinto beans, get your canned foods now, because every day they're telling us that it's coming, that this winter is going to be horrible. Whenever you watch the news, whenever you listen to the radio, even on the internet, critical thinking, it's very important right now. You can call it the elites, you can call it the Illuminati, you can call it the deep state, you can call it the president, you can call it whatever you want to call it. at the end of the day, it's Satan through man. And Satan is very good at what he does. And all we have to do is be ready. Pay attention, use their weapons to benefit us, and always look to God through Jesus Christ. Take care, everybody. God bless you all.